Yeah, we're going straight into the second map, Habitation Station, and starting to the top left with a 1-0 lead in the best of five series here at the quarterfinals at Aces ROG 2014. We see the Terran player for Team Millennium. It is 4GG with a great, great game one. And of course, he's going up against his Zerg opponent. Starting to the top right of the map, we have the evil genius. We have Jadong. And let's see if the Zerg player is able to win game number two and equalize the score in the series. Or 4GG is going to get an early 2-0 lead.
And it will be very interesting to see if Jadong will take that gold base. Most likely not, because you'd like to create distance between you and the Terran, whereas the Terran tries to close the gap. So primarily, it's a Terran base, but we'll have to wait and see whether Jadong prepared anything special for this map.
Yeah, usually what we see on this map is that the Zerg player either takes it as the third or the fourth base. Earlier than that is quite unusual. What we have on the other hand now for the Terran players, once again, this early gas. So we will once more see a few Reapers just trying to find out what exactly Jadong does. And on a map like this, where the push distance between the two bases is very small, as a Terran, you really want to know, is there gas? And how much gas did he mine? Do I really have to worry about him going into, let's say, a Roach push? Or is he just going to try and take an early speed for his Zerglings? But so far, Jadong just getting his hatch first, as you would expect already, going to follow things up with a pool here. And he's already with an Overlord in position to scout the barracks and will move into the main base to see the gas of 4GG. So those Reapers are going to be out very, very soon. And then let's see how exactly the Terran player is trying to open up this game.
And last game, 4GG overstretched a little bit with his Reapers. Of course, it is difficult on Polar Knight to get in and get out, just like Bilbo Baggins did. But in this game, try hard. In this game, it would be nice for 4GG if he didn't lose those two Reapers. They do add a lot of damage alongside with the first two, then four and six Hellions. And losing those did hurt him a little bit. And I feel like it kind of contributed to him losing his Hellions after that, because he felt antsy about how the early game went. So try to keep those alive.
Yeah, for now with 4GG, we actually also with Jadong, we have the gas taking. The Reaper is going to jump into the main base, and you of course really want to maybe even snipe the Harvester here, but that usually doesn't happen, especially when you go up against an opponent of the caliber of Jadong. You know that it's very, very unlikely that he could get a lot of damage done. And thinking about game one, he didn't even kill a single Zergling. That's how good the unit control of Jadong actually was there. But for now, the Terran player taking his own natural, going for the command center here, and just following things up as usual. Straight into the factory here for the Hellions. He's going to try to keep those Reapers alive this time, so that he can really execute a bit more pressure than he was able to do in game number one. But so far, the Terran is just, he's just doing his thing, trying to annoy the Zerg player as much as he can. He knows that once the Queen's out, they will put a stop to the entire harass. Doesn't lose the Reaper here. That's already everything that he wanted to do. And of course, the scouting information itself is already a huge win for him.
Yeah, it always seems to me very much like a dance. It's like two lovers, two partners dancing together. You both know the moves. You start in the same way, and then eventually it leads to, whatever it leads to. They seem to be making the same moves.
Usually sex.
And in this game, victory or defeat. Yeah.
I don't know. I wouldn't watch.
I'm glad you finished that sentence, Calder. Thanks.
You were thinking it.
I will never admit to that.
Well, Reaper number one is already down, and Jadong is chasing the second one hard. Of course, his own speed is about to be completed, and that's the time for the Reaper to get the hell out of there, since the Lings will be just way too fast and chase it down. And yeah, I don't think that Reaper is going to have a happy ending. Nope, he's definitely going to die here.
No happy ending for that Reaper.
Nope. And well, back at home, 4GG does basically what we saw already in game number one. He goes straight into the third base. Jadong also now claiming his third expansion here, or the second expansion, the third base, going into additional gas. And it's very likely that we just see the standard stuff from Jadong again. But actually, he's going into a Roach one right now.
Okay, so is this going to be the four Roaches trying to chase away the Hellions, get my creep spread up?
Yeah.
Or is it the four Roaches that move directly and ignore the Hellions and say there's 10 more coming where this came from?
Nah, it's way too late. And with him taking the third base, he's going to get 4 to 6 Roaches and then just try to work against the Hellions. I don't really see him too overcommitting against this. He's not up against Mech. We already see the Stim upgrade for 4GG, and that's something that Jadong will find out very soon. I would be a little bit surprised if he goes for a lot of aggression there, but he has quite a couple of Overlords lined up. So actually, he could go into he's going into 8 roaches here, a lot more than I expected. But with the extra overlords that he built, it really looks like he wants to push on through bases. Not really a timing push where he says, like, I want to win the game right away. So far, it really looks like he just wants to poke a little bit more. But now we have a Baneling Nest suddenly on the production tab, and that changes things.
Yeah, yeah. It does look like your initial thoughts about this game, about Jadon's capricious nature and tendency to launch into unexpected all-out attacks are coming true, Calder. He is doing a big roach attack on this map, this time backed up by Banelings.
Yeah, I actually thought he would, if he would do one, I thought he would really do it on two bases, but he does it with three and a little bit later than I would have expected. Currently, his harvester count is at 39. And, well, with a Baneling Nest, he can do a lot of damage there, but 4GG already kind of knows what's going on. So, back at home, we see double Evolution Chamber going down for Jadon. He wants to do damage here, but he's already joining up behind it. So this is not really an all-in. This is something that is designed to do a lot of damage, and he's risking a lot with it. He's already sacrificing economy, but his thought here is just, I want to do damage, I want to put him in a bad place, and back at home, I just follow it up with macro. He already took down the Hellions. Now he's moving in. We have a lot of bunkers there, but not a lot of Marines and Marauders. And there are not really a lot of Widowmines. Banelings following through, taking down the SCVs here. And Jadon is on the move, getting a few shots of the Widowmines off here. And at the same time, of course, trying to keep those roaches alive. But there's way too much Terran. But he already took a few units down. So let's see. 7 harvesters killed in total. Resources lost. Definitely better for 4GG. That was not really as much damage as Jadon was hoping for.
Yeah, he was droning behind it, and he's at 62 now, but it delayed his upgrades, it delayed his tech somewhat. Does he even have a lair? Yeah. That's really the main hurt here for Jadon. Economically, he's sound. Supply-wise and everything, it looks fine, but the biggest consideration is that his lair is only just starting now. At a time, 10 minutes, where normally a Spire is starting. And with the starport coming on the way, he might be looking a little bit miffed as medivacs are whizzing to this base and to that base.
Yeah, I like the thought process of Jadon. I would have preferred a little bit if he would have just poked with the roaches a bit earlier than that. I mean, the idea here was really not to kill the opponent, but just to do as much damage as he could, since he was following it up already at home. The problem was that 4GG identified very early on what was going on, added those extra bunkers, didn't take any chances there, tried to get the Widow Mines and, of course, then also the Marauders out. And he lost a couple of harvesters, but with a triple command center, with a triple orbital, you're not too worried about losing 6 or 7 SCVs. You can always rely on the mules, and you can go for the triple SCV production that will get your income up in no time. But for Jadon, we have now a position where he himself has 3 bases, is going into lair, nearly completed. But a bit problematic for him is really that 4GG is already moving out and claiming that gold expansion, and that will give his income a huge boost and advantage over the Zerg player.
Yeah, and you saw that Overlord hanging there, but it was with a lair 95% finished. Of course, the lair unlocks the ability to do generate creep ability on the Overlord, which would allow him to make the command center unable to land there. A move that Jadon has practiced and timed a lot. As you see, the Overlord was ready, but he wasn't able to do it because of his unusually late lair finish timing. Most of the SCVs that Jadon killed were actually prepared there. They were standing still to the front, so he's still comparatively lucky with the way that went. But in the end, yeah, it didn't do as much damage as he wanted, and now he's in trouble. 4GG doing this drop here. We saw the same thing against Snoot. But Banelings come here for Jadon, which Snoot didn't have yet, so that's going comparatively well for him.
Yeah, but a lot of Zerklings already going down there, and of course the Banelings finally putting an end to that. 4GG just simply lifts off and goes back. But we have still this double drop on the map, so he could go in and do damage another time. For him, it's important to make sure that the Zerg player doesn't have a gold expansion on his own. A nice spread there on the Widow Mines, really well set up. But for Jadon, we have a fourth base coming in right now, at the bottom right. That kind of makes up for the lack of the gold a little bit. And of course, always keep that Spire in mind that is about to be completed. So the Mutalists will then be able to do something against those medivacs. What I really would like to see from 4GG is actually a Viking, because he must have seen all these overlords just hovering around his bases with the medivacs already. There are so many of them. A single Viking would do so much. Now that the Mutalists are out, of course, it's a little bit difficult to really make that work. But if he has one Viking and can kill those overlords, that's 500 minerals just floating around his bases. So that would already be worth it. And it would also limit the vision of the Zerg player. A little bit too late for that. But we see a lot of Terran players getting that early Viking, and I really think it's a great idea, especially against someone like Jadon, who's always very map-aware and very positional with the Overlords.
Yeah, I agree with you there, Kaldor. If he felt like he could have spared it, he definitely should have made that one. But certainly very nice how Jadong has done it. So many overlords all around the map, including the bottom of the map, which may help him later as well. Two there and in the bottom left corner. So lots of options there for Jadong to use them. Now a big swing in with the Zerglings. The Widowmines are ready. How big will the explosions be? They're actually very well maneuvered by Jadong and didn't do a lot of damage.
Yeah, and he takes on the medivacs, and we talked about it several times. Those are the really important units, the expensive units that a Terran player has. Only six left for GG. We have another job, this time at the bottom right. And the one thing that he always did, and we see it here again, he's spreading the circle thin. He has units at the bottom right, at the top left. And it's just incredible. Everywhere we have Terran units just trying to do some damage, trying to go into the mineral line and kill more harvesters. Jadong is reacting a lot better than we saw, for example, Snoot react to this. He's able to throw it back, but just simply one time you're out of position and 4GG is going to punish you.
Yeah, now Jadong actually takes away the army that was defending the main. I thought, like, really? Are you bringing your whole army away? 4GG is going to do it again. But that's because Jadong says, now it's my turn. I'm going to hit you with everything I've got. I don't want to be in this position where you attack me left, right, until I get whittled away into nothingness.
That's where Jadong is really strong now. With the 2-2 upgrades, and 4GG is not there just yet. This is an upgrade lead that the Zerg player has, and Jadong is moving in right now, trying to go for those Widowmines, taking them down with the Banelings. A couple of really good shots going off before that happens, though. And the Zerg player already preparing for the next step. The Infestation Pit is now coming up on the production tab, whereas once again, the Terran player for Team Millennium has a double job headed towards the main base of Jadong. The scan takes down the tumor. I love that Jadong actually spread creep in his main base. This is so smart. It gives him vision. It gives him the speed advantage. But 4GG is already there in the mineral line, doing damage, trying to take down as many of the harvesters as he can. Could try to snipe that spawning pool a little bit later on too. The Zerg player still in a lead in overall army supply, but the Terran is just doing an incredible job once again.
Yeah, and this big attack that Jadong wanted to do in the middle never really happened. Oh, three Widowmines are about to explode on the Mutalisk.
Oh, that hurt.
That really hurt. Three died, and the rest is severely hurt.
But nice. Good snipe here on the medivacs. Really well done. And once again at the bottom, another scan going down for GG. Really trying to force the creep back. And think about how active he was, scanning and taking out creep tumors. And then take a look at the minimap. Creep everywhere. Jadong never stopping. Always sending the queens onto the map again and replacing the tumors here. Even in his main base. And I love that. There's too few Zerg players actually do it. And it helps him so much against this drop style that we see from 4GG. But the Terran player isn't done just yet. He's trying to make his way into the natural this time. But Zerglings from all directions streaming in and putting an end to it. And the Mutalisk, of course, once more on the prowl, trying to hunt down the medivacs.
Yeah, truly phenomenal job there on the creep spread by Jadong. And very nice injecting as well. He just lost the queen at the natural by that snipe out by 4GG. His supply is still looking really good despite losing aim. Oh my god! Those Banelings got hit as well as the Mutalisk.
Mule is really taking a lot of damage there, especially since the Marines are now moving in and Jadong moves his units back. He has a couple of Zerglings on the high ground.
And the Mutalisk!
And the Mutalisk once again completely out of position. And Jadong, oh my god, he loses all of them for GG. He unwraps his present and all the Mutalisks are dead. This is something that probably the Terran player didn't even expect. Jadong was busy somewhere else on the map, one misclick maybe, the unit control lacking for just a second, and the Terran player immediately capitalizes on it.
Yeah, that was way better than the wildest dreams of 4GG could possibly entail. Everything was going well for him, but that well with the Mutalisk, unguided projectiles for just a bit, suddenly 4GG capitalizes on this monumental mistake.
He's everywhere again. Top right, bottom right. He drops the fourth. He drops the main base. There's even a gold base coming up for Jadong already. But 4GG, he is once more everywhere on the map, doing so much damage. Jadong can't withstand this much pressure. GG. And the Millennium player goes up 2-0 against the Tyrant.
Unbelievable. Who could have predicted this?
Well, after yesterday, I thought it would be really difficult for Jadong to withstand 4GG's pressure play. But I thought that we would still go at least in a 4-game. So right now with a 2-0 lead, you need one more map. A single map is all that 4GG needs to advance to the next round, to the semifinals.